Welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see how efficiently configure the error handling in AEM. So this is the default behavior. The Sling error handler handles the error scenarios with the default error pages. Let's say like the scenario, the user is accessing for this specific page, usen.html, dispatcher check whether the page is in cache. If it is in cache, it will return it. If not, it will request the publisher for the same page. Then Sling error handler returns the error page if it is if the resource is not available. So based on the configurations, then dispatcher won't cache that error page and send the same response, pull the response to the browser or to the end user. So user will see the error page content, the 404 error page content. So all the websites display the same default error page. So let me show that maybe. Yeah, so if I go to this page like US, let's say I'm going to any of this page. Yeah, this is the default message. If I go to any of the site, even I will be getting the same behavior. Yes. So the behavior is same. This is the default error page of Sling handler configured by default. So every 404 request will get this response. Now this behavior can be modified by overlaying the Sling error handler to provide custom site specific error pages, but this will have performance impact on the publishers. The publishers should process the 404 error page for every non-found resources, as the dispatcher won't cache the 404 resources. See, the dispatcher in the default behavior, the dispatcher is not going to cache the response, the 404 response. So due to that, all this 404 or all this non-found resource request, publisher is going to reprocess or process those 404 page, the components what you have it in the 404 page, either it is a text component or whatever, the 404 page should be processed. So this will open the environment for a DDoS attack, DoS attack or DDoS attack. What does that mean is the attackers can send multiple bad URLs and overload the publisher. So why means the publisher has to process for every non-found request, the publisher should be processing the 404 page. That in turn impact the overall platform performance and make the platform unresponsive for the intended users. So this behavior can be changed by allowing the web server to handle the error scenarios, example 404, by enabling some additional configuration. So right now the 404, the error scenarios are handled by publisher, and dispatcher just pulled that response to the user. Let us now see the flow of the error handling through web server. Yeah, here in this case, user requesting the page, us/en.html, dispatcher check whether the page is in cache. If not in the cache, it will send the request to publisher. Then publisher will look for the resource. If the resource is not available, Sling error handler will send the 404 response. So now Apache checks if the response is for 404 and look for whether this 404 is in the cache. If it is not there because it's the first time, so it will send a request to fetch the 404.html based on the error document and the configurations that we will be seeing further. Now the publisher send the error response, and the Apache caches that the error response and send back the response to the user. Now here in this same scenario but little variant, the user is user request for a page, dispatcher identifies this is not in the cache and send the request to a publisher, and publisher send back the Sling error handler send back a 404 error response because the page or the resource is not found, and Apache checks and see that the 404 page is already in the cache, and so it directly send that 404 response to user So here you can see that Apache is not requesting for the 404 page again. So this is the performance improvement or security, whatever we were talking earlier. We are removing the additional request to the publisher for the 404 404 response. Let us now enable the configurations so that web server handles the error scenarios. I am enabled this the dispatcher with Apache, but the same work for IIS and other supported web servers with some changes. So as a first step, I created a site specific error pages. Let me show that. Yeah, so I will go to the site. Then if you see here, I am under V retail US EN. I created a English error page. Then ES, I created a ES specific error page. So you can configure like whatever the messages required, because okay, I am following this naming convention. So same 404 hyphen page, same thing for here also, the 404 hyphen page. So wherever you are creating for the individual language, you can create the same naming convention, because this path is going to be configured in the Apache dispatcher. Okay, now we created the error pages. Now let us now create the error handler. So in the dispatcher, let me log into dispatcher. Okay, I am in the httpd folder. I'm going into conf. I created a file with the name error handler.conf. Here what I'm doing is like just set environment if no case. I'm setting a variable. Taking the value from request URI, and I'm applying this regex. So this pattern should be changed based on your content path. I'm hiding the content slash v retail. So it's having the country code slash language code. So the pattern is enabled accordingly here. So if I go here, the first pattern and the slash, then second pattern. So then I am taking that and setting into this variable locale, so $1 and slash $2 means country code slash language code. Now I have this, this is again this dispatcher is running on Apache 2.4. It will support this if condition, if else condition. So I am using that. I am checking that if the whatever I assigned here, the variable locale, if the value is in one of this US EN, US ES, or whatever, I am just going and like invoking the corresponding locale error page. Locale slash, locale means here US slash ES or US slash EN, then the page name 404 hyphen page, because like my error page name is going to be same across all the language nodes. So if this is not for this one of this country and language combination, so this default error page will be displayed. My case, I am keeping the EN as the default error page. So if any of this condition is not matched, though, this default error error page will be sent. Here the error document is configured with the corresponding error code, in our case 404, and the error page path, the page or the content that should be displayed while the error occurred. Now, like what we need to do is, maybe now we need to include this error handler to the virtual host. So let me do that now. CD. Okay. Here I need to include that file, maybe. So including the error handler. So let me. Okay, that's fine. I'm included. Okay, now one more configuration change you need to enable, that the dispatcher configuration to hand over the error handling to web server, because right now the configuration is the default scenario is dispatcher handles the error errors and pool that response to user. So we need to change the configuration so that dispatcher hand over the error handling responsibility to Apache server. So for that, you need to go to maybe I enable the dispatcher configuration configuration the HTTP conf file. So I need to go there. Okay, I'm going here. Just let me search for dispatcher. Here there is a configuration called dispatcher pass error. So right now by default it is 0, so we should be making this to 1. You can read here like if 10 to 1, the dispatcher does not spool an error response to the client wherever the status code is greater or equal to 400, but passes a status code to Apache. Apache will handle the error scenarios with the error document. So that's what we configured already. Now let's restart the server. So okay, now let us go to the browser and test it. Okay, I am going to give some, yeah, this is for ES. Maybe it will give a default one. Yeah, this is a default one because we are configured for the, I will put something like a.html. Yeah, if you see, like it's giving the ES specific error page. So if I give a EN, it will give a EN specific error page. EN specific error page. And also, like if you give any other node EN other than whatever non-existent resource, so it will give the default error page. Again, it's a EN page. So yeah, now the error scenarios are like handled by the Apache, and also the error pages are cached. Maybe we can see that. If I now go to cd var, cd en, if I go, yeah, you can see the 404 page cached here. So same way, if I go back to ES, I can see the 404 page cached. So this will improve the platform performance and also the mitigate the security issues. Yeah, thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.